Welcome to today's edition of Crypto Corner at InvestorIdeas.com. News on what's driving the cryptocurrency market. Hey everyone, this is Sam Mowers here and welcome to episode 434 of the Crypto Corner podcast. For news today, Bitcoin appears to have resumed its rally. Square has reported a 600% quarterly Bitcoin revenue increase. Hut 8 has announced site management changes, and Dash has partnered with Taurus for a Latin American crypto debit card. But just before we dive into today's show, a quick reminder that if you enjoy this podcast, please feel free to share it or leave us a review. I also recommend checking out some of the other podcasts on InvestorIdeas.com, such as the Cannabis Podcast or the Clean Tech and Climate Change Podcast, both of which will bring you up to speed on the latest stock news and trends in their respective spaces. All right, so Bitcoin, after having fairly steadily remained around a trading price of $11,150 to $11,250 since Sunday, appears to have resumed its rally, according to data from CoinMarketCap. The flagship cryptocurrency is up just over 4% in the last 24 hours and is trading for about $11,615 at the time of recording. Now, Bitcoin last reached this price on this past Saturday, and on that occasion continued rallying to just under $12,000 before the flash crash that dragged it back down nearly $1,500. Financial services firm Square Inc., which trades on the New York Stock Exchange under the ticker symbol SQ, reported in a letter to its shareholders that it generated $875 million of Bitcoin revenue and $17 million of Bitcoin gross profit during the second quarter of 2020 on its Cash App. Now, this represents a revenue increase of 600% year over year, something the letter ascribes to an increase in Bitcoin activities and growth in customer demand. As of June, the company boasted more than 30 million monthly transacting active customers on its Cash App. Moving along, Hut 8 Mining Corp., which trades on the TSX under the ticker symbol HUT or HUT, has announced that the management of the Medicine Hat facility operations have been transferred from the Bitfury Group to Hut 8 itself, effective August 1st, 2020. The company had formerly outsourced the facility's operations and maintenance, but has now brought this in-house to reduce costs and streamline operations. Jimmy Viopoulos, the interim CEO of Hut 8, said, quote, "This transfer of the management of site operations will allow Hut 8 to work more directly with site staff to streamline operations and lower costs to continue our focus on being a low-cost Bitcoin miner. This will save us upwards of $500,000 per year, and I strongly believe this will benefit Hut 8, Bitfury, and our site staff." End quote. Cointelegraph reports that Dash, in a partnership with Mexican crypto exchange Taurus.io, will be releasing the first crypto Visa debit card in Latin America. Through the conversion of cryptocurrencies to pesos using the Taurus mobile app, the card will work at millions of stores in Mexico. Ernesto Contreras, the head of business development at Dash Core Group, told Cointelegraph, quote, "The Taurus card is a first in Mexico and the region, and it will also allow for a very easy way in and out of the Taurus ecosystem, which is very important as it adds massive usability to Dash users in the country. The fact that we are giving the opportunity for people to earn Dash back rewards with their card will also give a boost to the crypto ecosystem in Mexico, as now anyone can use their pesos and HODL Dash." End quote. That does it for today's Crypto Corner. If you would like to be a guest or sponsor for this podcast, contact InvestorIdeas.com. Investor Ideas reminds all listeners to read our disclaimers and disclosures on the InvestorIdeas.com website. And this podcast is not an endorsement to buy products, services, or securities. Investors are reminded all investment involves risk and possible loss in investment. To hear more InvestorIdeas.com podcasts, please visit InvestorIdeas.com/audio. And a reminder, you can also hear our podcasts on Spotify, iTunes, TuneIn, Stitcher, Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio.com, and Google Play Music.